Good morning. Today is Thursday, the third day of Iyar. And we continue in chapter 44 in the Tanya. The Alter Rebbe continues about the different levels of love to Hashem. We explain that there's two levels of fear of Hashem, two levels of love to Hashem. And generally, it is divided into the fact that the higher level of love is something that you receive as a gift from above. That's nothing that you can work to achieve it. The lower level of love, which is called Ahavat Olam, the love of the world, is when you meditate and you contemplate the concepts of the world and you realize how everything is Hashem. And then you develop a feeling of love to Hashem. And then the Alter Rebbe explained, as yesterday's shiur, that there is the third level of love. And that is a combination of both. What is it? We explained yesterday that there is an inherent love that we have in us, that we received as a gift from our patriarchs and ancestors, Avraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov. And this love is, he says, Nafshi ivisicha, my soul, I desired you. What does it mean? It is, you love God just like you love your life. Why? Because when you realize, you think about it, that Hashem is your life. So just like a child has love to smaller things, and an adult has love to greater things. So when we contemplate this concept that Hashem is our life and the true life is Hashem, so what do you desire? You desire Hashem. And when does it happen? Especially at night. Nafshi v'sicha b'layla, my soul desires you at night. And again, the words of this, my soul, I desire you. And we explained yesterday, what does it mean? We're talking to Hashem. We're saying, Hashem, you are my soul, and that's why I desire you. When does it happen? Especially at night, meaning a time when you feel that there is a lack of life. When a person is down and is weak spiritually, then he wants to once again to be connected. So this is the love that has both elements. The element of that it comes as a gift from above. It is a gift that we receive from by our DNA from Avraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov. And then, in order to reveal it, you have to work it and then contemplate this concept. So you contemplate and you reveal something that is already given to you, that you have in you. This is the love, loving Hashem like you love your life. Today, the Alter Rebbe continues and says there is even a greater level of love. And that is loving God more than life itself. That's what the Alter Rebbe is going to explain over here. What are we talking about? The Alter Rebbe is going to say that in the end of the day, after all, when you love life, you love God like you love life itself, the end of the day, who is in the center over here? You are in the center. But when you love Hashem more than life itself, that means that you love, the center is Hashem, not you. I don't love God because this is good for me. I love God when I contemplate that Hashem is above everything and I'm nothing. And this is the inherent love that there is. We have it. We have it from our ancestors. And Alter Rebbe is going to explain also that it comes through Moshe Rabbeinu. We have it from Avraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov, but it goes through Moshe Rabbeinu. And we'll soon explain why. So this is, the Alter Rebbe is going to say, this is like a child who is ready to give his life up to save his parents. The love that a child has to parents, obviously we're talking about when everything is okay between them, Sometimes the love is hidden. Sometimes there's animosity between them. But I'm talking in a normal circumstances. In there, inside their child, there is a love to the parent. And the love to the parents, when it comes to tests, sometimes the child will be ready to give his life to go save his parents. If he knows the father or mother are in danger or in captivity, he's going to put his life on the line to go and release his father or mother. This is the love that we recognize that the end of the day, we are nothing. Hashem is everything. And the love, therefore, for Hashem is limitless, and it's more than life itself. So let's see inside. Look, Dalter Rebbe. Ve'av Rabba ugdoy lo mizo. There's a greater and more intense love than this, meaning than the love which results from realizing that God is one's true soul and life. That's what we spoke yesterday. There is a greater love. Vehi mesuteres gam kein bechol nefesh mi Yisrael. And this is also hidden in each and every single soul of every Jew. Biyerusha me'aveisenu, this comes as an inheritance from our ancestors. Hi mashakosu b'rayim ha'imne, this is what it says in the Zoya, in the part called Rayim Hemne. Kibro de ishtadel basar avoy ve'imei, like a son who strives for the sake of his father and mother. He tries everything to do for them. The rochim loin yatir megarmei v'nafshei v'ruchei. And he loves them even more than his own body, soul, and spirit. So therefore, he's ready to sacrifice his own life to go and save the life of the father or the mother. So this is something which we know that Moshe Rabbeinu reached that level. However, at the end of the day, every Jew is also a child of Hashem. Ki aloi av echad lakulano. For have we not all one father? Don't we have all one father? We have, at the end of the day, every Jew has this concept that we are a children of Hashem. Hashem is our father. Says the Alter Rebbe, but wait a second. Do you think really you can achieve a level of love to Hashem like Moshe Rabbeinu? You can achieve this level of love that you are going to be one and you're ready to give your life and you're loving Hashem more than you love yourself? Says the Alter Rebbe, Va'af, ki mi uze ve'eizehu asher orav liboy. Although one may ask, who is the man where is he? Who would dare presume in his heart to approach and attain even a thousandth part of the degree of love felt by Moshe? To receive even a thousandth of the level from the level of the love that Moshe Rabbeinu has. How can we say that every single Jew has that love? Nevertheless, as the Alter Rebbe, mikol makayim arei efes kotzeyu v'shemetz minhu. Nevertheless, a minute portion and a particle of His great goodness, merav tuvei ve'oiroi, meir leklolus Yisrael b'chol doyer v'doyer. It shines, it illuminates to the community of Israel in each generation. Every generation that shines a tiny bit, a spark of the neshama of Moshe. Moshe Kosova Tikkunim, as it is written, it states in the Tikkunim, in the Zohar, the ispashtusei bechol doro vedoro leanhoro loin vechulu. That an emanation from him, from Moshe Rabbeinu, is present in every generation to illuminate them. So is that's what Alter Rebbe says. There is in every single Jew from Moshe Rabbeinu. Rak she'or zu hi bibchinas Hester ve'helem gadol benafshos kol beis Yisrael. The only problem is that this glow of Moshe's soul is present in the soul of all Israel in a manner of great obscurity and concealment. It is concealed. Now, and to bring out this hidden love, Mea Elem Vea Esther, from its concealment and from its latency and concealment, Ela Gilu to be revealed. Liyos Bizgalus Liba Yomaichoi to be revealed in a revealed manner in his heart and his brain and his mind. Says Alter Rebbe. It is not beyond, it is not far, it is not beyond reach. It is very close to you in your mouth and in your heart. This is the verse that Alter Rebbe said in the beginning of the Tanya. The whole Tanya is based on this verse, that the Torah is not far from you. It's not far, it's not out of reach. It is very close. It is very close to you to be able to achieve. How? In your mouth and in your heart. You would think that it would say, it says over here, at this level of Moshe Rabbeinu, not everybody, it's hidden, and therefore you would think that the end of this statement would be you have to work very hard to reveal it. And Alter Rebbe says no. This level of Moshe Rabbeinu is hidden in you. And in order to achieve it, it's very close, it's very near. How to do it? Says the Alter Rebbe in your mouth, the verse says, in your mouth and in your heart. The Alter Rebbe goes to say that when you're going to use your mouth, verbalizing constantly this concept, I'm a Jew, I have a neshama, and I can reveal it, and we have the Ibishta is my father, and I can give my neshama to my father, and so on. Talk about it, the voicing it, the verbalizing it, and contemplating in the same time, not just saying, but contemplating about it. This will help to reveal it, that you should actually feel it as much as you can. So it continues, Alter Rebbe de Hainu, which means, that is to say, it should be habitual with his tongue. Make it as a habit. Vekoiloi. And the voice, le'oira kavonas libo yomaychoi, to arouse the intention of his heart and mind. It says the sounds of one's voice arouses devout concentration of heart and mind. That's why when we pray, we always pray. We don't just verbalize. We don't only read it, we make sure to verbalize it. And not only verbalizing it, but verbalizing it with a voice. We're saying it with a voice because the kol me'ir ha'kavana, the voice, when you say something with a voice, this arouses the connection, the concentration. Leha mik machshavtoi becha yeyachayim ein seif baruch hu. So as to immerse his thoughts in the life of life. The blessed Ein Sof. You think about it, what is the real life? The real life is not the physical life that we live. The real life is the life of Hashem, the life of Ein Sof. Ki hu avinu mamesh o amiti, because he's our true father, umekor chayenu, and he's the source of our life. Ule'oirer eilov ohavo ke'av asabein elov. And to awaken our love for him, like the love of a son for his father. And when one accustoms himself to do this continually, habit will become nature. Habit becomes second nature. It becomes our nature when we think about it constantly. And we asked earlier, we mentioned, it seems like a little contradiction. It says that this love, this hidden love we have from our ancestor, the patriarchs, Avram, Yitzchak, and Yaakov. And then it says that it comes not from them, it comes from Moshe Rabbeinu. So which one is it? So the Rebbe notes on this, and the Rebbe explains that there is the love itself that comes from the others. That comes from Avram, Yitzchak, and Yaakov. But once you have the love, you need to know how to use the love, how to implement the love. Moshe Rabbeinu is the Das. Das means the connection. Just like in life. Some people have level of different qualities, but they need to know how to implement the qualities. So the Aves give us the love, give us the Midah, and Moshe Rabbeinu gives us the ability of using it and connecting it, that we should connect to this love in a way. That is why it's called the Raya Mehemne. This is the love. And when we contemplate about the greatness of Hashem and we reveal what we have hidden in ourselves, this is the love to Hashem that is greater than love for life itself. Because that is the true life, is the life of Hashem. So this is the end of today's shiur. This amazing message we take from here. Again, that we should meditate, we should verbalize our davening. Every day, tata, tata, we say to the Eibishter and so on. And this will help us to connect to it with the Kayach of the Neshama of Moshe Rabbeinu. Thank you so much for joining. And make sure to share this with your friends, with other people. All the best. Any questions? If there is some time left, we can and take some questions now.